So I'm at the Boy Scout camp. This is the first sort of break spot on the trail. So I'm just taking it easy today. This is my first hike camp in quite a while. Recovering from a shoulder injury, so just taking it slow, enjoying it. The plan is just to get there without getting injured, and then, you know, cook up something good, hopefully get a good sleep, and then, you know, be out early in the morning, have a full day tomorrow. So so that's the first of the big three. There's about three big hills that I need to do to get to the campsite. So that's the first one. We're doing pretty good. Considering that the last time I tried to do this, I dislocated my shoulder for the fourth time. I had to get surgery and it took me out of the game for about six, eight months. So that was the last time I did this. The time before that, I got all the way to the campsite, realized that I had lost one of my water bottles, full ones, so I had to turn around and hike out. So how about the third time is the charm for the maiden voyage of all my equipment and stuff. So we'll see. Point over there. There it is. Right there. So what I gotta do now is set up camp, set up my tent. There's no shelter out here. It's totally exposed, so I'm lucky right now. It's overcast, but when the sun comes out, it just beats down. So I'm gonna set up camp. Got my tent set up. It is hot. I'm baking in here. It's too hot to do anything else. Just gotta sit and chill right now. I knew it was gonna be pretty hot, but man, it's foggy today, so there's no wind. It is baking. Baking. Yep.
my Ultralight cot Thermarest. Yeah, try it out. Raining a little bit, so finally cooled down. Kind of got my camp set up a little bit, so start cooking, start drinking, and yeah, just time to start enjoying that camp life. All right, setting up to cook. It's kind of raining a little bit, so like usual, but it's kind of breaking down all my stuff here. Of course, you gotta have the hot sauce. So I've got a few things here. So normally when I come out here, I do most of my cooking on a Trangia stove. Love it. Works well in high wind, in all weather, and honestly, if it wasn't for this, then I wouldn't be out here doing it. With the Trangia stove, you know, you can use alcohol fuel, but I like to use isobutane with the burner. You get a little bit more control over your fire when you use this. So let's get this set up. And the shelter that I'm using today is a Ultamid 2 Hyperlite mountain gear. First time using it. Hopefully it's gonna work. And given that it's raining, oh, it looks kind of some dark clouds. I'm probably gonna just cook right here. It's a little bit more cramped than I would have liked, but you know, I got the camera kind of poked out as far as I think I can go, and you know, that's why I have a big shelter, so I can cook in the rain. We're gonna be doing beef stew tonight, so Cody Black's famous mountain beef stew. We're gonna be drinking Lagunitas Maximus Colossal IPA. I only chose to bring one. Usually I like to bring two tall boys, but I only brought one this time. I want to save on the weight, but as always, most important part of camping, you gotta have your whiskey or your rum, as it is this time. So yeah, we're pretty much set. Let me get things going, and then, you know, let's start cooking. Another thing that I will run through this board here. It's an ultralight collapsible cutting board by Wild Cascade. Folds up into this real small, and it's like kind of like cardboard. It's like a plasticky cardboard, so it works really well, really, for what it is. Works really well for what it is, and I got a little GSI Outdoors cutting board here, so it's for chopping later. knife that I'm using today is the Backpacker Bowie by Topps Knives. First time I'm using it, so I really love this knife, man. It is just, it's awesome. You know, it's awesome. So thank you, Topps, for making such a cool little, like a small profile bowie knife. It's really cool. But before we start cooking, now time to start drinking. I'm ready for this, man. Lagunitas Maximus Colossal IPA. 9%. It'll do it. Nothing like a nice warm lager, or no, IPA up in the mountains. It really does hit the spot, I gotta say. Oh yeah. Oh. That's good. That's good. I usually dry brine my meat, so these were dry brined the night before.
Koolau rum. It's the best. I'd like to thank all my sponsors, the North Face, Patagonia, Goodyear, always keeps my tires fresh and good. Stay Puff, Marshmallow Man, any kind of campfire you're doing, Stay Puff Marshmallow is the way to go. Arcturix, Osprey, you know, can't forget about Osprey, you know, their lifetime guarantee. Big mahalo to them for sponsoring this video. Locals, slippahs, no better slippah for beat your dog and beat your kid and slap one cockroach and kill one centipede and run faster when you put them on your hands. So, you know, big mahalos to Locals Slippers for sponsoring this video. Whole Foods, you know, Jeff Bezos, you know, brother Jeff, I was drinking with that guy the other weekend and, you know, he was like, bro, Cody, you should go camp. So, you know, here I am. Microsoft, you know, always Microsoft, even though, you know, you got to download the virus protection, you know, Microsoft. Apple also, you know, mahalo for sponsoring this video. I get one Apple computer and, oh, some big dragonfly. Apple, you know, bruh, yeah, Apple. What else? Who else are my sponsors? Miller Lite. It's always Miller time. Big mahalo to Miller Lite for all of the good times and also all of the bad times. You know, that's life though, right? You cannot have one without the other. So, yeah.
good stuff, baby. There we go. Alright, here we go, baby. Beef stew and rice. This is a big plate. full fool.
Time to start packing up. I want to get out of here before it gets too hot. So the cot ended up working okay. One thing that I liked about it is that it kept me off the ground, so I didn't have to worry about if it did rain. I didn't bring any kind of bivy or anything. Usually I do in the pyramid tent with no bottom. I always usually have a bivy sack, but this time never had and worked. I think if it stormed, it would have not been good, but one of the reasons I did this was because the weather was real nice, and yeah, I think we did okay. Okay, key part of the hike now, getting back, getting out without getting injured. Should be easier because my pack is like 10 pounds lighter, but it's going to be wet, it's going to be more downhills, higher chances of slipping, but I got a good feeling, so let's do it.
So, on the way home. Yeah, that was a pretty successful hike camp cook. Yep, so if you guys got any questions or comments, or you want to see me cook anything or whatever, you know, leave me a comment. Subscribe to my YouTube channel. New videos every time there's another hurricane in Hawaii.